WSBW weather with Jim Vanderzwan.
So far, so good as we head into that last weekend before Christmas, at least to the West Coast. To the north, we're getting some rain and snow in the Pacific Northwest. Heading into the Intermountain West, everything else is pulling out of the Southwest. Going to make a mess of things. We'll talk about that elsewhere in the country. But for us, we expected a cool night. We got it down to 27 Boulder Creek, 30 in Scotts Valley, 34 in Santa Cruz. But upper 50s to low 60s pretty much rounded out the top end of the day with mostly mid to upper 50s around the peninsula. It's a little nippy this morning in Marina, 32 there, 33 in Carmel and 29. That was in Carmel Valley, down to 27 in King City, but mostly 60 degrees, 62 in Salinas this morning. So we had a little nip of frost there, but it didn't last all that long, and we're probably done with it. I think most of it's going to be a little bit warmer over the next couple of days. Also, same kind of temperature in Santa Clara Valley. And the Central Valley ended up with a 63 Sacramento, 10 degrees cooler in Bakersfield. Then you got some 60s going in Southern California, cold enough for snow in the mountains, and after you get on the other side of the Sierra Nevada, it gets cold. 31 Boise, 25 Denver, 6 was the high today in Bismarck. Dallas still made it 68, while Chicago only saw 36. So there is some warm air on the side of the country. Colder air is dropping down. Dallas now down to 39 degrees. New Orleans 71. They'll be cooling off tomorrow, but this boundary is very dramatic. Very warm air on one side and very cold air on the other side. That makes the potential for some serious weather that much greater. Rain right now, but a lot of ice and freezing rain already pushing into northern Texas and Oklahoma. Snow in the Great Lakes. You got scattered showers of a mix of rain and then some freezing rain in there. And as this thing continues to move east, that boundary is going to get really nasty tomorrow. Tornadoes are possible in December. Yep, it does happen from time to time. This upper level trough gets the moisture, the cold air from the north. This will continue to work across the map. This is for tomorrow. Sunday it'll be on the East Coast. There'll be a lot of travel plans kind of scrambled around while we sit under this dome of high pressure for a little while longer. Looks like this on the satellites. You can see all the clouds arcing over, and they're going to drop down into the bottom end of that trough, the other side of us. 5,000-foot temperatures stay fairly mild here. We've got that offshore component at about 4,000 or 5,000 feet, and that usually reflects it fairly mild down at the surface. As you can see, all the cold air is well off to the east of us, and this will stay that way for the next 3 or 4 or 5 days. So we're going to see temperatures at least in the 60s. Wouldn't be surprised to see a couple of 70s, but with tomorrow being the shortest day of the year, that won't be around all that long. Locally, here's the Monterey Bay. We get a little bit of chill down in the valleys, but we get a little hint of yellow that gets some 60s going there. Winds again east to northeast in the morning, get a little northwesterly breeze in the afternoon, so it's about as good as you can get it. Perfect weather to be out and about and celebrating your Christmas parties and doing a little shopping and the like. Temperatures overnight, mostly mid-30s to 40s, except a couple of places close to freezing, but not long enough to be a problem. Highs in the upper 50s to about mid-60s tomorrow. So that's actually about normal for this time of year, so may as well enjoy it. Coolest will be out in the valleys near the coast. Temperatures closer to 40 degrees by and large, and upper 50s to low 60s for highs. Across the bay, likewise, looking pretty good. Mild weather with sunshine still feels good, but you know, it's still December. You got to remember that. Clear and cold is how we're going to go for your Friday night. Tomorrow, we're looking at sunshine. A little breeze in the afternoon, some spots up to about 20 miles an hour. Less of that on Sunday. East in the morning, northwest in the afternoon, so we'll call it mild for winter standards. And the nighttime temperatures, like I say, by and large, with one more night with a little nip of frost in some of the valleys, we should be able to move above that and keep everybody in the mid-30s to mid-40s for most of the run going into Christmas. Daytime highs, 60s aplenty. May as well enjoy it. There's no chance of rain before old St. Nick gets through here, so that gives him good flying weather, and then we'll see what else we can drum up around the end of the year or the beginning of next year.
Hopefully we'll get some rain soon, but in the meantime, I'm going to enjoy this.
Stay on this side of the map, though,
yeah, exactly.
If you know what's good for you, really.
Yeah, I do know what's good for
you.
Yeah,
some places you're not going to be able to get to because of this storm. This is going to be stretching for, you know, 1,500, 2,000 miles.
And it's nasty
stuff,
a lot of freezing rain.
A lot of awful stuff.
That black ice, which is
And then after that's gone, the power's out and it's cold and it's just not much fun.
Yeah.
Stay here.
Okay.